As students, you might be wondering, what is Founders Day all about? Well, some of us have put together a small insight into who was the founder of Shawnigan, C.W. Lonsdale. I'm currently sitting at his desk in our magnificent museum. So here's 12 things to know about Christopher Windley Lonsdale for our students, and as a little refresher for our alumni.
He was educated at Westminster School in London, England. There he played soccer and cricket, but he did not excel academically. In fact, on his 1902 report card for mathematics, it read, "Very bad, has made no effort."
In his early 20s, Lonsdale came to Canada and tried his hand at many jobs such as farming, logging, hotel manager, and taxi driver. He even tried to enlist in the Canadian Army, but he was turned down based on medical grounds.
Welcome to the Shawnigan Lake School Museum. In 1916, C.W. Lonsdale carved Shawnigan Lake School out of the Canadian wilderness. He began with six students, and he then remained its founder and headmaster for the next 36 years.
Lonsdale was a rower. In 1917, he won the Gent Single Scull at the Shawnigan Regatta.
Hi folks, as you can see, I'm standing here in front of the main door to the main building, obviously at the school, and behind me in gold is the school's motto, Pomum qui meruit ferat. The founder, Lonsdale, was inspired by the brilliance of Horatio Nelson, the great admiral, who won the Battle of Trafalgar but sadly lost his life. An interesting tidbit that you probably don't know is that Horatio Nelson, in fact, is one of my ancestors. And somewhere out there, there was a Horatio Nelson Hyde Lay. True fact.
Lonsdale planted this acorn from Sherwood Forest, England,
home of Robin Hood.
And now this tree has been here for 91 years in front of our beloved lake's house.
Lonsdale was a visionary educator. He dreamt of a school to endure in all future time and to educate future leaders of his adopted country. His wise words of 1928 have helped guide us through the pandemic. I wish you to consider very carefully whether it is wise to remain stationary when opportunity is so obviously waiting for us.
Hello everybody, my name is Grace, and some of you may not know that I'm the great-great-great-niece of Christopher Windley Lonsdale. So today, I'm going to be reading his favorite prayer, what we call the Founder's Prayer, which was originally written by Sir Francis Drake. The prayer reminds us of the importance of not just the beginning, but the challenge and the endeavor of the journey that each of us are upon. It seems to capture Lonsdale's dogged determination, his great endeavor, to carve a school out of the wilderness in 1916, and his lifelong dedication to the development of Shawnigan. So I'll read it for you now. O Lord God, when thou givest to thy servants to endeavor any great matter, grant us also to know that it is not only the beginning, but the continuing of the same, till it be thoroughly finished, which yieldeth the true glory. Amen.
A statue of C.W. Lonsdale welcomes all of our guests to campus. C.W. Lonsdale was a smoker, a detail which the sculpture included in this. He was also a lover of dogs, who he trained to chase mischievous students. He incorporated this love of dogs into his educational philosophy. An extract from Time magazine 1947 reads, Lonsdale patted his German shepherd Judy and pointed a moral. If I had let Judy run wild and do as she damn well pleased as a pup, she'd be a vicious beast today. You can't develop leaders by letting them do as they damn please when they're boys. If nothing else, we're training boys to be less obnoxious.
Hello, I'm Dom, head of school. I'm here in my pajamas. I wanted to talk a little bit about this statue. It acts as an installation and interactive piece of art, from Easter egg hunts to April Fools. And today I noticed that a small ball has been inserted into the dog's mouth by a mischievous student. Go fetch!
Lonsdale is buried in Parksville, and every year, early February, on his birthday, we lay flowers on his grave as a mark of respect.
I'm sitting here in Lonsdale's pew in chapel. My favorite thing about Lonsdale is that he was a bit of a rebel. He didn't follow his father and older brothers to Cambridge University and into a career in the church. He rebelled as a teenager. He never made it to university. In fact, he was a remittance man, someone who was paid by his family to go away for fear he became an embarrassment to the family. England's loss was certainly Canada's gain, and he created a school out of a rainforest. He stands as testament to the fact that you don't need to be the top student at school to succeed in life. I'm certain this resonates with students, alumni, and staff alike. He knew what it was to fall from grace as a teenager, but he rose again with a great desire to do good. He wrote poignantly, "We all may have fallen from grace, but we all at one time had a great desire to be good." On Founders Day, we mark his vision and celebrate all things Shawnigan.